what we have here is the traditional R66, but what we've done is taken this aircraft and we're installing our SkyOS system. No cyclic, no pedals, no collective, a single control stick that allows the pilot to operate the aircraft in every flight profile required.
All right, well, let's do it.
Okay. Confirm cabin heater off. Okay. Do that stuff. All right, confirm area clean.
Okay.
And now you're going to just slide over for the engine start. And we'll go and put the typical six pack, completely automated engine start. So you don't have to have your hands on the controls, right? This is a full authority fly-by-wire system. It can hover better than you can.
Dude, automated. It's off it. Really? No
completely
kidding.
Completely off the controls. You're going to push the white bar and just slide it to the top of the box. There we go. Power's gonna start to increase.
Torque.
Yeah. Take a seat just like in a typical Robinson, like the red seat comes up, and you get left in the light.
Oh. All
right. Now we're in the hover. Right on the center line, high stable hover.
Yeah, so what we've done, we've removed all the standard traditional helicopter controls, and we've put all that functionality into a single control stick. You have a forward movement to accelerate, backward to decelerate. You have a turning motion, and as well as a twisting motion at low airspeed and in the hover to perform a pedal turn.
All right, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do a pedal turn. And this is how you're gonna start getting used to the feel of the controls, right? So you're already starting to figure out yaw. Mm-hmm. So you can see with the deflection, how much you deflect it is what rate you're gonna command. And as soon as you release it, it's gonna capture that hitting.
So, and that's what we would do with the feet before.
Correct.
Okay.
Okay.
That's a max pedal turn, right? And now release. Boom, it stops and heading hold.
So it's definitely different. I think what I'm more excited about the most is that I think my wife would fly in this with me at this point. And she's scared to death of helicopters. And I think this will more remind her of a car and all the safety features in this thing. I think she'll be willing to fly with me places.
This is the thrust lever, right? So, or thumb control lever. So put your thumb on it and you're gonna push up. You don't have to push up. Now let it go. All right, we're going to stable that down about 120 feet. And you can see, based on like, you know, the displacement is how much I'm going to climb. And if you release it, it's going to go back to zero.
So it's going
to
hold it at 60 feet?
It's going to hold it at 60 feet.
Wow.
We're just going to enter the pattern. Hey, one of the things I talk about with guys is, you know, you're in the pattern, let's say tower's like, hey, traffic, 10 o'clock, 1 mile factor, right? Typical helicopter, like I still am like, you know, where am I distant? You know, where am I at? I'm still looking for birds. You know, probably only 60% of my brain space is looking for that traffic. A typical helicopter, you're not taking your hands off the controls during a takeoff like that, right?
No.
You know, I'm trying to remember.
Of course not. Yeah. You can't.
So how do you select the speed? Yeah, how do you?
You're just going to push forward.
Okay.
Yep. And hold it. Remember, hold it until you see 60 on the white. So
55, okay.
56, 57, 58. And now release the back pressure to the center. And it's going to hold 60 knots.
Okay.
Can I tweak a little bit of rudder and see what happens?
You can. What it's going to do is put you a little bit out of uncoordinated flight. So it's basically like, yep. See how it's putting you out of uncoordinated flight?
Yeah.
It almost makes it feel more like an airplane where, you know, you don't have to be on the control full time like you do helicopters.
What it's doing right now, at low airspeed, below 30 knots, you never want to be more than 300 foot per minute rated descent because you'll enter what's called vortex ring state.
Yeah.
Right? And so that's another example of the flight envelope protection. And the other thing it's not going to let you do is hit the ground at 300 foot per minute, right? So now I want you to take that thumb control lever and go all the way down. So you see how it's stopping you at 300?
Oh, yeah. Right? Yeah.
And so think about, you know, I got a high rate of descent. I'm coming in. I don't realize that I've slowed below 30 knots. It's automatically going to take a lot of that descent rate out, even though you're full down.
Yeah, nice.
Right. Let's start our turn to the right. So one of the things you have to be careful of is a lot of people, when they turn right, they either like to push forward or pull back. You want to try to keep it right in the center and turn to the right.
Yeah.
Again, helicopter, like, as I start turning, if I overbank, I'm going to lose altitude. Well, I've said, hey, stay at 600 feet. MSL, and so it's not going to let me lose altitude. So full deflection, go all the way to the stop, right? It's not going to let me overbank, right?
Okay.
Right? I could overbank, right? Because my lift vector comes up to my rudder. I could overbank, but I would descend.
Yeah.
So it's limiting my angle of bank because I've commanded something else, right? If I wanted to descend, I could descend and it'll let me do a higher angle of bank.
Huh.
Right? So that's another function of the dynamic flight envelope protection.
Interesting.
It'll stabilize out, make that left turn to go back to the runway. A little bit more backstick.
We're looking for the refrigerators.
Release the thumb lever for a second. There's 30 feet. Yep, now you're right over the runway. We take our hands off the controls. This is going to maintain a hover over the spot that you're at.
And then I can...
Yep. Swipe down. Here, see the power starting to come up nice and steady. Looking at the data on the landings, like, it's pretty impressive.
You're really not flying much. You're giving it a command of what you want to do and monitoring, which is good because you can do other things, other tasks.
Yeah, this is going to change the aviation a little bit as far as helicopter.
Yeah, we think so.